Ramen, ramen, ramen. So good, they made two museums for it in Yokohama. Come with us as we check out both. I'm joined by our resident ramen expert, Yoshitaka.
Hi, konnichiwa.
We're here at the Shin-Yokohama Ramen Museum, a great place to try ramen from all over the country.
The museum area has a full history of ramen in Japanese and English. There's a host of other displays too. And there's a chance to hand make some traditional noodles. And don't forget the gift shop. When we went, there were 8 restaurants available, but they do come and go, so there's always something new to try.
Okay, Yoshitaka, where are we now?
We are at the Hachan Ramen.
Okay, what's big about Hachan?
Hachan Ramen is quite popular in Fukuoka, and when the announcement Hachan Ramen joins the museum, it was actually a news. Everybody, please.
Big news.
Big news, yes.
Okay, bring it on. Okay, so what kind of ramen is this that we have in front of us now?
This is a tonkotsu ramen. Tonkotsu ramen is based on pork bone broth from Fukuoka, and Fukuoka is quite famous for that.
Is there anything specific about the type of noodle?
Hakata tonkotsu ramen is quite famous for, and even strictly for thin noodle.
Thin noodle?
Yeah, and usually harder than any other kind of ramen.
Right. Hard and thin. Let's tuck in. Right. Chopsticks, please.
Yes.
いただきます。いただきます。いただきます。 So, first of all, try the soup. Oh, yeah, that's very a very porky.
Very porky. Okay.
Very porky taste. It's really good. Really good. Noodles are a little hard, but not too hard.
Not hard, but in Fukuoka Tonkotsu Ramen restaurant, you can order the at your preference.
Yeah.
From hard to soft.
Okay, so this is really good, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Good tonkotsu. There's another tonkotsu restaurant here as well.
Oh.
What I want to do is compare the two.
All right, let's go.
Let's go. I'm gonna finish this first, and then let's go.
Let's go.
Okay, we're now having tonkotsu ramen again, but this one is from Kumamoto. Before it was Hakata.
Yes.
What's the difference?
Yeah, so tonkotsu ramen from Kumamoto is less salty than Hakata ramen, and it's kind of sweet, actually. And it's famous for fried garlic. You can see it on the top.
Yeah, I can smell it. It's very strong as well. Let's dig in.
Yep,
dig in.
That's right.
These noodles look a little thicker.
Yeah, definitely.
I can taste that garlic. Does your soup taste more good too?
Somehow, yes.
A little. What about your meat? How's your meat?
Looks yummy.
Is it good?
It's good.
It's not actually meat. That is a vegan ramen.
Really?
Yeah.
That's
soy meat.
Oh, really? I didn't know that.
And the broth is also soy as well.
Oh my god. Really?
same as regular ramen?
Well, if nobody tells, I can't realize actually. Yeah.
Ramen Museum, vegan friendly. Okay, that's two down. We got two more shops to go to.
Oh,
can you do it?
Of course, why not?
Let's do it. More ramen. We're now at Shin-Yokohama, and it's a Yokohama ramen, right?
Yep.
From Yokohama. So what's a typical Yokohama ramen?
Actually, there's no particular Yokohama ramen, but Shin-Yokohama serves two of most traditional ramen introduced in Japan, which is shoyu ramen and shio ramen.
Okay, yeah. And that's soy sauce and salt.
Exactly, yeah.
Nice. And I hear the owner is a bit of a rock star.
Actually, the Mr. Sano Minoru, he is one of the most famous Japanese ramen chef. So it's kind of Japanese Gordon Ramsay.
Thank you. Thank you very much. All right. So, yep. いただきます。いただきます。いただきます。 It's your soy sauce. Soy sauce ramen.
It's nice. Nice and smooth.
Ooh.
Thank you. Traditional taste.
It's salty, the oil in there. It's clear, but it's not too heavy. It's quite light, but full of flavor. Not overpowering.
I'm struggling. He's still going strong.
Yoshitaka, we are at our fourth and final place.
Oh my god.
But you can eat more, right?
Yeah.
No problem.
I'm not full yet.
So this last place we're at is called Yu's Noodle Bar.
Yu's Noodle Bar. Okay.
It's not Japanese.
Okay.
It's not even Chinese.
Oh.
It's Canadian.
Canadian. Wow, that's interesting.
Canadian ramen.
Okay.
We've got chicken miso ramen.
Chicken miso ramen. That's inviting actually.
Inviting? Okay, Canada, show us what you got. Chopsticks, please.
Here you go.
Thank you.
Okay.
Yep. Itadakimasu. Come on, Canada. Oh, quite thick noodles.
Yeah. The soup is quite creamy, like a potage.
And the chicken's pretty good as well.
Do you reckon the Canadian love this taste?
I think so. Maybe it's made for Canadian taste. Canadians, please come here and tell us what you think. So we've been to four places now. What would you say was the best one that you had today?
Okay. It's not a fair question because I used to live in Fukuoka. So I would choose Hachan definitely. Yeah, it reminds me a lot. Yeah. I love every kind of ramen actually.
There's a German one you can try as well.
Yeah, that's quite interesting. German ramen is just over there.
Yoshitaka,
yeah.
We just had five different ramens. We've had a lot. You full?
Not yet.
He's gonna go for more.
Yeah, why not?
Well, we're finished here. Next, we're gonna go to the Cup Noodle Factory on the other side of Yokohama. Yoshitaka, thank you very much.
Thank you so much, too.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Let's go.
The Cup Noodle Museum is in the Minato Mirai district of Yokohama. There's plenty to do around here, like the theme park behind me and Chinatown.
Whereas the Ramen Museum was about eating as much as you can, the Cup Noodle Museum is more educational and very interactive and hands-on. It speaks a lot about the innovation of instant noodles.
いらっしゃいませ! You may be worried that all the information here is in Japanese. Don't worry, the app and the audio guide are both in English.
You can also order noodles from around the world here too. Why don't you share a picture of noodles from your country in the comments below?
There's noodles from Kazakhstan. This is ragouman. Really good. Okay, what we got here is a bit odd. It's a cup noodle ice cream. This prawn is the same that you would get in your cup noodle. Interesting.
The two big experiences here are My Cup Noodle Factory and Chicken Ramen Factory. In the latter, visitors can make chicken ramen from scratch. It takes 90 minutes and requires an additional fee and a reservation, and you can check the description down below for details. Today though, we're gonna design our very own Nippon Traveler cup noodle.
You gotta buy a cup from the machine, it's 300 yen, got ours down here. Ta-da! Okay, now it's time to design our Nippon Traveler cup noodle. Almost finished. Okay, I think I'm done. Nippon Traveler Cup Noodle. Right now it's empty, so it's time to get some noodles.
Next, it's time to pick the soup flavor.
Okay, chili tomato, cup noodle flavor, seafood or curry? Which soup should we have? Seafood, I'm going to say. Seafood.
Next, we need to choose four toppings. Let's add some crab flavored fish cake.
Lastly, we've got to put in its special packaging. There we go. All done. Okay, so there you have it. Two museums, two different takes, one for eating until you pop, and the other for getting innovated. Come to Yokohama and try them out both.
Thanks for watching. Let us know about your favorite ramen in the comments down below, and while you're at it, don't forget to like and subscribe. Gochisousama desu.